What's the deal, guys? It's your boy back at it again with another banger.
What's up, guys? It's Nick Racel with the 392 WideBody here. Well, I'm going to explain to you basically what I have here. It's a 2019 Scatpack WideBody. It has some aesthetics done to it, but it's pretty much stock. I have a couple things done to the exhaust, a mid-muffler delete, a resonator delete, and an active exhaust fix. It's called the MF1. It keeps the active exhaust open all the time. Tire stickers, actual vinyl tire stickers that look pretty nice on it, and I just got the taillights and side markers tinted, but that's pretty much all that's done to it.
Man, this car is beautiful, man.
Still stock scat, but
man, it sound amazing. For you guys new to the channel, I'm from Michigan, so the whole Detroit car scene is a big Dodge commercial, but his scat, one of the cleanest ones around, for sure, most definitely. So, you know, we just going for a drive, man. He got the whole interior done. The carbon fiber. Tread band. So, you gonna add power soon? Or are you just gonna keep it stock?
I mean, I paid for a warranty, so I gotta kinda like wait that out at least. You know, I do eventually wanna do shit to it, like headers, intake, headers, cam, injectors, E85 tune, with the trains tune, full exhaust, Corsa Extreme, hopefully, you know, Cook's headers, I already said headers, but the Cook's mid pipes.
This one optioned out pretty nice.
Yeah.
Got the Alcantara suede on the seats. Y'all know I love challengers with the sun. I had to. Perfect. But yeah, what was you about to say? Man, he got the scat pack for the seat belts.
Oh yeah. The only thing I would have got different is the red interior. I do wish I got the red interior.
Yeah.
But everything else I love.
I actually seen one for sale. Cause as y'all know, I've been looking for a new car. I haven't gave y'all a channel update, but I changed my mind on that. Y'all gonna figure out why. But I was actually looking for one, and I found one. It wasn't a wide body. It was white like this, the red and black interior.
Okay.
Hard. Oh my god. But nah, this clean, man. She clean. He got the white dice.
Yeah, it's actually for my dad's old Trans Am.
Your dad had a Trans Am?
Yeah.
Man.
It's an old 67 Trans Am Firebird. It's white as well. Kind of got the resemblance with him. I wanted to make this look like a classic American muscle car.
Okay.
But like modern muscle.
Right.
Same time. So.
Now I say this. Out of the big three, I say from 20, 30 years from now, Dodge is really gonna only have like a classic car. Like these are gonna be classics when we in our 50s.
Forever. This is the only big three muscle car that resembles the old.
Yeah, cause like
back, and the body lines are about the same. You know, everything's pretty much
right.
The same. Lights are just. Maybe a little facelifts and whatnot, but
what I was gonna get into, like the Camaro. It's funny, I was about to bring it up and we riding next to a RS. But for instance, the Camaro and the Mustang are more of a track-oriented car. Like that's the Alpha 2 body. They came after the 4th gen, the 5th gen, that was the last time the Camaro was really a true muscle car. The fifth gens are heavy. They're big, heavy. That's what
this thing's heavy too.
They had the LS7 back then, the 7 liter, but now Chevy and Ford went to a whole nother. It's really a sports car market. Dodge is the only one that's still making classic
American
big
money.
Engine, big car. I don't give a fuck.
Yeah.
It's gonna be fast either way.
America.
Yeah.
I can get out of here a little bit.
Yeah, you're gonna do a couple of pulls. Setup. I can't talk about it too much because they don't know yet. Well, my new setup,
it's gonna be moving
how I want it.
Yep,
about 550, 536.
I just dynoed this car at one of those last meets too. They were running a free dyno, and I just said, fuck it.
Yeah, I seen. Yeah,
made 397 horsepower at the wheels. Obviously.
Yeah. Yeah, this thing sounds
but apparently Craig horsepower stock for these is 485 with yeah. 475 foot-pound of torque.
But it's like, when you get like with automatic, it's like 18% of drivetrain power loss. So yeah, that makes sense. That's the only good thing about a manual, I'll say. Bro, a manual is more hassle to drive. And I actually seen a lot of these with a manual in them.
Yeah, the Scatpack wide bodies?
Nah, it wasn't a wide body, but a scat in general. But with a manual trans, it's less drivetrain power loss. So they are faster, but you're not shifting faster than the computer.
Right.
It's over. Now, what radar do you have? Because I actually need one.
It's an Escort Max 360. It's pretty good. It tells you like the direction the signals are coming from. You can, it remembers. So say you get like a K-band, or I'm sure you guys know if you have K-band or any of the bands. If it picks up the same signal in the same place, like twice from like a, you know, like signal from a light, it'll cancel out that signal and because it has GPS in it, so it remembers where it's at.
Smart.
Okay. Yeah.
So
exactly like that.
Tell the people on YouTube. How much does it cost, just maintenance wise, like the Brembo brakes, how much does it cost to own a scat?
Well, gas is pretty expensive. That's the biggest downside, probably, for sure, is, you know, you gotta put 93 or 91 on this. So, you know, paying right now, like, $3.50 a gallon to $4 a gallon.
Right.
So, that's quite a bit of money. So, within a week, I drive it only to, like, meets and stuff. And sometimes I drive it, like, daily. But right. It depends what day it is. If it's raining, I don't really drive it. Maybe fill it up maybe once a week, so that's like $50 in gas a week, and the oil changes are pretty expensive. I take it to Dodge to get it, you know, make sure that they're doing the right thing and putting the right oil in.
Right.
That's like $120 of oil change. Other than that, I haven't had to do anything with the Brembos yet. I haven't had to replace the brakes. I only have 18,000 miles on here.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. So
low miles.
Right. So I haven't had to do anything with brakes, but okay. The brake dust is annoying. I would say that. So you can get like ceramic brakes, which removes the
go brake with dust. The power stop has.
Power stops.
They're carbon fiber ceramic. They smell funny as fuck, but trust me, you will not have no brake dust. And the stopping power. To me, I feel like the stopping power gonna increase even more from. Brembos. What you got, six pistons?
Yeah, six pistons in the front and four pistons in the back.
Okay. So you got the big brakes.
Yep.
So this whole little, I've never got to play. I've driven this scat like once.
Go ahead and play with it.
So you got like the sports setup.
Yeah, you can make like a custom setup for you, you know.
Okay. You got the performance screen. Yeah, everybody be saying that. It take a second. I've driven a scat charger one time. That was it. Okay, so we track. So did you have this on when you was going down the track or no?
No. But this is like a live dyno. It tells you
right.
How much power and how much,
right.
What RPM and what gear it tells you and everything. I'll show you.
I'm about to say, I gotta see this. Okay. Yeah. That's crazy.
That's pretty cool.
So then you got, what is this?
Oil pressure, pump on a torque, your horsepower again there.
Okay. You got G-force. You got like oil temp.
Shows all your temps.
Oil pressure. Coolant temp. Battery voltage. Trans temp. Now you should have had this on down the strip for sure. Yeah. Okay.
But it did record it. Like, I didn't want to look at it. I should have. But on here, it tells you, like.
It tell you on there?
Yeah.
Performance. Lap timer.
Quarter mile time. 12.7 is the best.
12.7?
8th mile time. 7.9.
Okay.
The best. 9.8 seconds, and this is not real. It's because when you do a burnout, it registers that it hits 60, so it says my 0 to 60 best a half a second. But that's not true.
Okay.
I would say it's around like 3.5 seconds, maybe closer to 3.
Okay. Yeah, guys, y'all gonna see this car on the channel a lot. Way more often. Hopefully we can get some runs in.
Yeah, once you get your car up.
COVID shipping is just ridiculous right now. I'm waiting. I got Speed Engineering on this 7/8, like the big long tube headers,
okay,
down to the true dual exhaust. I have no cats, no resonators. The exhaust is like the they big is probably just dip me up dash. They like little big. The muffler is little as fuck. The quad tip, so yeah.
she gonna be
screaming. Yeah. Remember guys, follow him on Instagram. I'm leaving a link to his Instagram below. I'm probably gonna put his Instagram somewhere down here or over here. Remember to like, subscribe, and leave feedback in the comments. Y'all blew up my last car review. I'm about to check where it's at right now. Did you watch the Lexus?
Yes, I did.
He was doing that burnout in my neighborhood. I got so many comments like, bro, he doing a burnout on the Lexus like it's a scat. I'm like, welcome to Detroit, man. We slide everything.
Oh, yeah.
Bro, I need my YouTube to love.
So I see this video blow up for sure. That'd be dope as fuck.
It seems like y'all like car reviews, so. Because it's almost at 20,000 views, like for sure.
The Lexus one?
It's at 16K. Okay. I want to get the exact number. I gotta flip the camera. The last car review I did, y'all got me to 16.5K views. My camera wasn't gonna focus. It's cause my phone screen, I got that protector on it. But y'all got me to 16.5. So guys, let's run it up. This ain't no 07 Lexus. This
is 2019 WideBody Scatpack.
Yeah, this is a big boy. So y'all gotta run it up, man. Remember to leave a like, comment, subscribe, and thank you. I'll hit y'all with the next one.